Every single piece of debris, having already been combed through at Ground Zero, went through three more passes under the careful eyes of officers and agents of the FBI and the NYPD.
We always look for three things: human remains, personal property, and evidence.
Investigators for the first inquiry by the Federal Emergency Management Agency, or FEMA, were on the scene immediately. Every inch of the site was picked over by hundreds of people. No one reported any signs of explosives.
Able to move 120 dump trucks out of the city last night, which will give you a sense of the work that was done overnight. So some of the debris has already been removed. More of it is being removed, and it'll be done by barge all throughout the day today.
Recovery crews led cadaver dogs through the rubble to pick up the scent of the missing. Debris was trucked off site to nearby barges and then shipped to a landfill where it was searched once again.
The debris is dumped into the hoppers, divided up into three categories. Less than a quarter of an inch, that's basically dust, there's nothing to it. Quarter of an inch to about 2 inches and over 2 inches. The detectives sit along the conveyor belts and they'll pick out those three categories that we're interested in.
When Rudy started his scoop and dump operation, just 101 FDNY members had been recovered. 242 FDNY members and hundreds of civilians would either stay buried at Ground Zero or be removed like garbage and deposited at the Fresh Kills landfill.
In a structure that is taken down with explosives, you would find these tubes. You would very likely find the upper portion of this cap where the delay element is.
Stands out to me quite a bit. I think the fact that I haven't seen a door, I haven't seen a phone, I haven't seen a computer, I haven't seen a doorknob, I think that stands out. Thank you.
my team would have found something. Of the thousands of photographs we have, you would have seen a piece of a blasting cap, a piece of debt cord. Not one in 5 years, not one piece of real evidence to substantiate these claims. A lot of circumstantial claims, a lot of innuendo, a lot of whack-a-mole, which you explain one thing away and they mention something else, and it never ends. But the reality is, this far out, no one has been able to provide a single piece of evidence that those buildings were explosively demolished.